just myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year. Stole many a man's soul and faith. I was around when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain. Made damn sure the pilot washed his hands and sealed his fate. Pleased to meet you. Hope you guessed my name. But what's puzzling you is the nature of my game. Stuck around St. Petersburg when I saw it was a time for a change.
Today's Magic 102.3, DC's R&B station. That's my girl Fantasia. She's back. Bittersweet. Also, make sure you check out her television show on VH1. They have decided to renew it for another season, so we'll see that. Enjoy her very much. Well, that's pretty much going to do it for this presentation, but I got to tell you about this story off of TMZ. Katherine Jackson, the mother of the late Michael Jackson, is downsizing the number of grandchildren in her San Fernando Valley mansion. And the stun gun incident was basically the catalyst. Sources with direct knowledge of the situation tell TMZ that Catherine has told Alejandra, I'm not even going to attempt to pronounce this last name, but basically they're currently living at the estate along with two of her kids by Randy Jackson and two others by Jermaine Jackson, and that she must take the kids and get to stepping by next week, because supervising seven children is just a little too much for the nearly 79-year-old grandmother. So this concludes my work day, which is always pretty hectic and crazy, and of course I've waited till the last minute to do things that I need to get done, but this is not the end of my day. Right now I'm headed into production to do some commercials, and then, as I do each and every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, I'm going to my dialysis center to get my blood cleaned, as my daughter says, and oh, that is an exciting adventure. You will soon see, so stay tuned.
I'm Alex McKamey, account manager here at Radio One, and I'm on Olivia Fox's marketing team, and I've been knowing her and listening to her for years. And just truly in love with her and the things that she do for our community. On this event that's coming up, it's imperative that we all come together to help our community and just help folks know and educate folks about the health, good health of our people.
Hi, this is Venice, and I work with Olivia at Magic World 2.3. I've only known Olivia for like a year and some change. And, you know, she just surprises me every day with her just natural wit. I mean, just the things that she talks about. She just has that, she's in the right position. I mean, Olivia is one of those type of people that you don't come across every day in life. And even just knowing her story with the kidney and everything, it's just phenomenal that she's able to do the things that she does and not miss a beat. So, you know, this gala is going to be something spectacular. It's going to be wonderful. Like I told Olivia, God's got a purpose for you, and he's going to blow your mind once it all opens up for you. Love you, girl.
Olivia, an amazing person. She blessed my life, enriched me completely. I love the relationship that we have. Some days we fight, some days we love, and some days we fight. But I can't think of another person that I would want to be my friend in a time of a pinch, because I know she's got my back. I love you.
Okay, so when I'm on my way to treatment after work, normally I'm flying, usually, because the sooner I can get there, the sooner I can get home to my baby. My baby gets home from school at 6. So I'm always trying to get there at like 3 or 3:30, so I'll be done roughly at like 7, and I'm only away from her for like an hour. But before I go, I always have to call them and let them know that I'm on my way. So my chair is ready when I get there. And hopefully... This is so illegal. I know I'm not supposed to be talking when driving. Oh, that's my joint right there.
Now, people wonder how I get through what I'm doing. This woman right here speaks to me. Dorothy Norwood, there is not a better gospel singer on the planet. Yes, I like that. When you're always used to doing and going and being your own person, and then all of a sudden somebody tells you that a major organ in your body is not working, and not only that, and if you don't go and get treatment, you could very well die. Kind of brings you down to earth. Kind of like a pin in a balloon, and kind of deflates the whole situation. So, and another thing that dialysis does for me, it makes death real. Most people don't deal with death, but maybe once a year, if that. You may hear about somebody that you know that knows somebody and they die, or every once in a while you have a family member to pass and you deal with it. But being a dialysis patient, I practically see death 3 times a week. Either death or things that look very close to death. People that are very, very sick. You have these strong bonds with people. We just lost someone at the center about a month ago. You know, there are people that are, you know, I won't say always dying, but, you know, the reality of the fact is, you know, when you're in a dialysis center, you see and hear about people dying regularly. So it really, death is like right here. So that's another thing. But on the positive side, because I always try to be positive, it lets you realize how short life is, and not to sweat the small stuff. Because you can be gone like that. Last September, on the anniversary of my dad, God rest his soul, the day of the 1 year anniversary, and a tech can explain this a little bit more, but sometimes when you go into dialysis, you get weighed, and I'll show you. And the way they calculate your regular weight, your dry weight, with the amount of weight that you have on you, most of it they assume is fluid, they pull that off of you. When they pull the blood, they pull the liquid off of you, because that's the work of the kidneys when you would go to the bathroom. But sometimes the calculations are off, and as a result, your blood pressure will crash and you'll pass out. And sometimes you die. And last September, I had a situation like that where my blood pressure crashed and I was talking and then I was out. I was awake, but I couldn't see. And I couldn't move, but I could hear everything. And one of the techs told me that when people die, you have to be careful when people are transitioning from this life to the next, because your hearing is the last thing that goes when you die. Something I didn't know until I almost died. But I heard everything. And then I came back. I opened my eyes and I came back. But I had crashed. My blood pressure dropped, and I was gone. So that's 2 times I've almost died. But by the grace of God, I'm still here. So, scary though. Very scary. Very scary.